Now here you go. This is what I do, y'all, to really make my cheekbone pop. I highlight right like this little V. Now I did learn that from what's his name? I forgot. My name is Monique Carr, and I'm here with Bat Me Cosmetics, and I'm here to show you how to elevate your slay. Legendary children, my name is Monique Hart and we are here, honey. We're gonna get into some cosmetics. We're very excited to be working with Bat Me Cosmetics, honey. It's black owned, black realness, black royalty. Thank you. Okay, so before we get started, you know that priming our skin, taking care of the melanin that you're in, honey. So we're gonna be using some primer. Okay, so let's get started with that. Let's take off these glasses. You know I don't wear lenses, but I just wear it for the, you know, the oohs and the ahs, right? Lovely. Now, we make sure that we take care of our skin because quality cosmetics and bad skin don't go together, okay? So you didn't spend all this money to buy this sickening palette, but your skin, you know, they don't do that. So drink water and moisturize, okay? And always go up, okay? Now, I also like to use a light misting spray just to kind of get us started. So just two spritz, you know? Ooh, ready to go. Now, legendary children, now I know that, you know, we are all learning how to do makeup, and for those of y'all that love to cross-dress for Jesus, like me, or those who just like to play in cosmetics, if you're gluing your eyebrow down, try this step. Glue it down, but don't do your whole face, okay? Try this step, work with me. It might be a little process. So what you would do is you would glue your brow down, set it, forget it. You know how you do it. Clean up the excess, powder it, conceal, then put a brow on. That's what I'm gonna do. I use my own brows. I like to use a brow liquid like a pen, just so I can kind of get in there and do what I like to do. The good Lord bless me with eye space, children. Now here you go, if you get one good brow and the show is running and you might be a little late, wear a bang like Aaliyah that day if this one is jacked up on this side, okay? There we go. Sisters. Now we're not gonna finish the rest of that song because we don't have the copyrights, okay? And we don't wanna pay extra checks, okay? We don't. Okay, now we're gonna go up under the eye and clean it up with some concealerette. Turn to your neighbor and say concealerette, concealerette. Elevate your slay, honey. Now here you go, here's a tip. If you know that brows are something you're gonna struggle with, right? Maybe put the time and energy there first, okay? So that way you give yourself time. I had this one sister named Taj, and girl, if she did not give herself enough time, she would be like frustrated and running so late because them brows, girl, gotta be right. So make sure you take your time. As a showgirl, darling, and the good Lord has blessed to be a working showgirl, okay? Because there have been a lot of us girls that are not working, so I thank God to be a working queen, amen? Thank God for the small things, amen? Right, boom. But it is very exhausting. I love it, though. I love meeting all of these new and fans that go, you know, just to be so close to you, just to touch you, just to smile, just to see your performance, just to hang out with you and Kiki for that show that day. It's really kind of fabulous. But then when I get home, y'all know what I do? I crawl into bed and get on my phone and I scroll on that Uber Eats app, girl. Ooh! And I just let have. And I gain a little weight and then I go work it off. But I'm telling you, that's what I like to do, girl. And there's this one restaurant in LA. If you come to LA and visit, this is where I live now. I moved to Hollywood. Thank you. on the Uber Eats app specifically. Postmates ain't got it. I don't know what you're doing, but you need to find out. I don't know about DoorDash. I don't have them. But Miss Chicken Day in Koreatown, girl, when I tell you the chicken is right, I don't know who these little Asian women are, but girl, it's right. Okay, so as we bring down the concealer, what you wanna do is you wanna bring the concealer down. You for sure wanna cover that crease, right? But you wanna cover that outer corner and that inner corner, right? And you wanna leave this midsection kinda bare. And I'll show you why. When you go to clean up and really give yourself a very clean cut crease, you want it to, you know, not have that, like, sometimes I like to go in with a makeup wipe or that micelle water and really, really like, but if I don't have time for that, if I just wanna go in with a white cream and really cut it, I don't have all of the fallout, all of the products, so therefore it's not mixing, and therefore, once again, it makes your colors pop as bright again. So, the reason you do bring it in this corner, because when you bring your shadow over, you want it to have something to adhere to, okay? Here's another pro tip. If you wanna do the whole halo smoky eye, which where you put like a shadow, like, you know, a brown, and then you put like a lighter brown over that, or a dark brown or whatever, and you just, essentially, a smoky eye, right? Create a smoky eye. And then if you wanna pop the middle, boom, just put a little glitter right there. Boom, you've already set yourself up for success. They think us black folk don't know what the hell we doing, but bitch, we do, okay? We've been watching Susan, okay? It's our time. Thank you. Lovely. I'm using the Box of Donuts palette. Now, here you go. Listen up. It's vegan and it is gluten-free. Can you say that about some of the other products in your makeup collection? No. Okay. So this one is, we're going to open it up. So it has a little, you know, shell. Lovely. Take that off. You know what this reminds me of? For those of y'all who are in elementary or was in elementary, you know, y'all remember when y'all had to take the book covers? Girl, you could decorate them. Or if y'all lived in the hood like us, your teacher would give you a brown paper bag and then give you some stickers to put on it so you felt special. Here you go. But that's what it feels like. You just, ooh, very that. Okay, now let's open this up. This is cute. Cute packaging. Metallic. We're into that. Okay, the donuts look good. You ain't bring no extras. Shade. Okay. All right. What is speaking to me? She is catching my eye. I'm really living for her. Okay, this is when you know cosmetics is good, right? When you can just lightly touch it and you feel it just on your hand. Here we go. Look at that. Oh yeah, she's very bad. And we're gonna go on with this yellow. This vibrant yellow, and we're just gonna pick up the product. Now this brush is fluffy, but it is a little dense. And the way we're gonna go, we're gonna not just go in and just swoosh, okay? Y'all just be swooshing sometimes. Just be, You want to pat the product in and really pack it in, okay? So that's what this looks like. Now before we go in, we just wanna make sure now, I have what you call hooded eyes. And hooded eyes mean if the camera, can you zoom in? Lovely. So do y'all see how it kind of like folds? That's a hood, essentially, right? So you see, girl, ooh. I might need to get Botox up under there. But the rest of the skin is still tight. Okay, lovely. Anyway, a hooded eye. So you want to pat, okay? Pack that product in, right? And you see, I really have not even really like lifted up the brush. I am just pounding that in there, day. Get up in that kitty. Okay, put a little bit more on the brush and we're just gonna pat, pat, pat. Lovely, right? And then you wanna go in and swoosh, okay? Softness, treat yourself right, love on you. Get up, ooh, yeah, softly, lovely. Love me. And blend that color out. Lovely. Now here you go, here's another little tip. When you do have a hooded eye, you kind of have to blow out just a little bit more so that way when you open your eye and you look on, you can see the color, right? Now, notice I did not bring that blow or that smoke out of this yellow all the way to the white eyebrow highlight point, right? Because we want to put a shadow there, so you want to kind of control that as well, right? And you see, like right here, we maybe have maybe like a fourth, an eighth of an inch, a fourth of an inch of little space. Keep that there. Don't blow that out just yet. You can do something fun there and put like another color or something. You know, you might just get inspired. You are an artist, you are creative. Be free. So here we go, y'all. You know, remembering that you are an artist and you are free to create and be whatever you want. Makeup has evolved. You know, we are living in a time where makeup is at I would call it a renaissance in a sense. And looking at my makeup when I first started in drag to looking at it now, like, now it's truly about the details. On social media, you'll see everybody does the whole like 2016, 2020, 20, and seeing the difference, seeing the growth. And you just really, I got this phrase from Amanda Seals, and she goes, the dopeness is in the details. And when you really give yourself to the details of makeup, such things as like drinking water, good skincare, quality cosmetics like that. You know what I mean? The dopeness, and then you start to, you know, apply differently, and you just see the overall success. You look at your sister. My makeup truthfully changed because I was always pretty. You could never say, even when my highlight was super bright, I was still cute. Bright, but cute. These cheekbones was good, honey. Okay, now here you go. Bright but cute, but my makeup changed when my little sister, because is Valentina older than me? I don't know. She's still cute, though. She said, come sit next to me. It was day two of promo week for All Stars. Day one, my promo shot. I don't like my makeup. Why? Because I was rushing. I was late. My flight was delayed. And I was feeling like they were looking at me, the subconscious BS of, you know, what us black folks go through, thinking that, So I rushed, and I hated it. Day two, Valentina says, meet up. Come over here, sit, let's go. We're gonna take our time. And you're really, she said, really like enjoy the fantasy. And that's when my makeup started to evolve. I started to enjoy the fantasy of creating and not just putting on a face. So enjoy the fantasy of creating. All right, so I like to go in with white, and I like to put it on like the lash line, like it's liner, and then you look up, and you see where that line is, you see where that new, that's i.e. your new crease, okay? Now I'm gonna let you know that on this eye, because it folds a little differently than this one, I have to go just a little bit higher. Now I'm gonna go from the inner corner of my lash line and just pat. Boom, boom. I'm gonna use this other yellow, shimmery one. And so we're gonna go on the outside, working our way in. Oh, she's pretty. I'm a part of a lovely production called Nubia with the lovely BB Zahar Bonet. We have the lovely Peppermint, Bob the Drag Queen, Shea Coulee. And this one, this our New York dates, will have the lovely Vixen as well. We wanted to start our own productions. We were like, why are we waiting for people to, you know, give us an opportunity to perform instead of taking our own opportunities? Like, no, the power is in our hand. God has given us this gift and ability. He's given us the feel. All we have to do is work it. So we decided to do that, and that's what we're doing. So please come on out. In the words of Mark Singer, Dusty Ray's Bottoms husband, it's not Manhattan, but keep that in there. It is in Brooklyn, but it's cute. It's at Roulette. It's gonna be very, very fabulous. We want you to be there. Show up looking cute. We'll take photos for the meet and greet. I'm gonna give y'all the gag. Legendary children, I just wanna add a little drama. We like to accentuate our positive, honey, so our cheekbones are here, right? So generally, in drag, you know, take a tip where you can. most people paint out here, right? But I want to pull. Also, this is another little tip for if you're a woman or a man of a particular age, if you elevate your makeup, meaning your blush, your contour, and if it's sitting here on you, it pulls the face like a facelift without having to do tape or go under the knife. There you go, you are welcome. Listen to mother. Here we go. Also, don't cover your highlights, specifically in drag. If you are going to make this come forward, don't put foundation there and then put another color over that. Now, if you are cisgendered or whatever, lovely, whatever, and you do want more of a natural, softer, then put your foundation, put your concealer on. That way it looks a bit more, you know, natural. But if you want a little bit more dramatic look, then don't. I also bring my forehead foundation low. I don't do a whole lot of forehead highlight. It looks unnatural. Even look at Naomi Campbell. She only highlights to there, okay? You look real fish. And some people contour all the way down here, but your cheekbone is up here, so why you bring, don't do that. On the bone. And remember, we wanna pull it here. So we just went in with, we just sculpted it, right? So contour shouldn't go from here to here, unless you want to. The arch of your eyebrow and that high point meet where most people put highlighter, don't go past that with your contour. Remember when we talked about our brows in the beginning? Boom. How we can kind of clean them up at the end. Now, the reason I also like to clean them up, I don't know if you're still zoomed in, are you?
Yes.
Lovely. Y'all see that my forehead has vitiligo on it, vitiligo. And so me literally putting this concealer stick on it really is a better application. And it's thicker and it kind of covers a little bit better. Okay. I put it right in between the brows. Now, when you take your beauty blender, don't just go and boom. I say start in the corner with that tip right there. And pat, and blend. And that way you almost cut the side of your nose. Boom. And then take that on back. Lovely. Now here we go. We're gonna go in with our brightening color. Now with this one, we want to concentrate that light just blending out right where we put it. Not necessarily like spreading that color through, but just literally blending it. And what you will see is that you get a brightening effect that is multidimensional, without just looking pale across your eye region. And so we're going in with the shade Stop Being Poor right up under the eye, just to kind of brighten a little. Oh, she brightens lovely. You don't have pores, there's nothing for them to read you about, children. And I'm just gonna bring back the depth to my face. Once again, starting on the high part of the cheekbone in the back, swirling. And I like to start closer to the hairline and work down, okay? That way you control the pigment. I learned that tip from a lovely queen in Orlando, Florida. Shout out to Miss Rachel Summers. Shout out to Rachel Summers. Okay, so I know the trend is for drag queen and for women to now, you know, people just cut up under their cheek like that, right? That's the old staple. But here you go. According to your face shape, you should highlight differently up under your jaw. So if you have a wider jaw and you do a highlight like this, this is gonna pronounce and make that jaw pop out. So maybe you wanna highlight something like this. Just in the front. So that way you pop here, but not back here. Get my drift? Educational moment. The more you know. We're gonna dust that. Now the reason I think we should use orange is because on our skin tone, sometimes trying to find the right shade is hard, but an orangelo will give you always the right, like, just flesh tone. It just kind of brings you right back to where you need. Not a whole lot, just a little bit. Don't use red, just an orangelo, and it just kind of
tans the skin just ever so lightly.
Lovely. So, most people put blush all the way down here on their apples, right? I'm gonna put it right here. Pack, 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 so that way it's concentrated. So I'm taking this teal cyan kind of blue color, and I am taking it with a stiff flat brush, and we're just literally patting this under the eye. All right, so we're gonna go on with some liner. We're just gonna add some thick liner. Alright, so I'm getting ready to apply my velvet lash. Let's open up and take a look. Alright, these are the premium. This was seen on Drag Race, this was seen on Pose, and I'm gonna put them on too. Lovely. Nobody should be using Weave Bonded no more. Them days is over, okay? Lovely. Zodiac on the tip of the brush. All right, and this is the finished look, honey. Filling the yellow with a little bit of tequila sunrise, or, you know, no tequila if you're, you know, not old enough to drink or sober, you know, whatever. Lovely. Cute. We use the Bat Me Cosmetics, the Box of Donuts palette. We use this lovely yellows and a little tincture of this Urangelo and some of this blue for the under eye, some of this shimmer. In the middle, we have the lovely Zodiac, darling. Let's do that again. Y'all can cut that in post. We have the lovely Zodiac, darling, on the cheek. Thank you. So I'm feeling my plus, I'm feeling my beat. I'm feeling my, feeling my, feeling my, ooh. I'm feeling my, feeling my, feeling my, ooh, 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 ooh. Check out my new EP, Beloved. iTunes, Spotify, Cloud9. That's not a third. SoundCloud, that one, yeah. You can follow me on social media. I only use Instagram. You can message me on Facebook. I probably won't check it, but okay. Follow me at I Am Monique Hart on Instagram and on Twitter. I love you so much. Stay tuned, darling. Oh, you can also catch me on Netflix. Episode 7 of AJ and the Queen. Specifically, episode 7. It's the best one. Quality acting, darling, thank you.
Sounds good. All right, that's it.